Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another video for premium per user series, where in this video we are going to see what are the AI capabilities you will get when you have this premium per user license. Let us check it out in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notifications. So these are the different features you will avail with Power BI Premium per user, along with the pro user, whatever pro user used to get. There are other advantages or features you will get, but these are the top notch. In this video, we'll focus on advanced AI, that is text analytics, image detection, and automated machine learning. I'm not going to focus much on this. I will cover the text analytics like sentimental analytics, and you can also have some other kind of text analytics that is provided default by Microsoft. Let's check it out in this video. I'm in Power BI now, and I got some data set where you will have some such comments, right? Whether it is positive or negative, and this is the duration of the tweet. It is from a Twitter, and what is the age and country from where they have commented. And for this, whether this particular user or this comment, whether it's a positive comment or negative comment, that is a sentimental analytics, right? So doing it manually will take time. So for that, we'll go for data science projects, AI, like NLP. Those kind of stuffs are called machine learning. Basically, this is one of the NLP project that comes under the umbrella of data science. So in Power BI, how it will be useful? Like, we have something over here that is AI insights. So this facility comes to you when you have a Power BI premium per user license. What we are going to do, whether this text, whatever he said, is a positive comment or negative comment or neutral, right? That is what we are going to predict. So let us try to use this functionality. So go to text analytics, then choose the column that you want to get the sentimental. Let us try to get what are the text analytics you can do it in from Power BI, right? There is not all the NLP features you can implement. So whatever Power BI provides here are the most common text analytics, right? So you can see this is the detection of language. When you use this text analytics function, then it will detect the language, what language they have used. Now here, extract key phrases. So what are the key phrases used, right? You can have a very big paragraph or things, and you can extract what is the key phrases from that text. That is this particular functionality. In our case, we'll go for score sentiment. So I choose the text, this text column, and if you have a language, if you assume like you have for the same text, you have different country or language code, right? In that case, you can choose this one. But in our case, there is no language. It is mostly in English, so we will ignore it. Then you need to choose here based on the premium per user or premium per capacity. In our case, we'll go for this. So that is the superpower we'll get. And let us click on OK. So your duty is to just click on the some buttons, then just press OK. Then what happens? It is trying to pass all these rows and try to get the sentiment score for your records or data. So it will, what it will return is like, it will return the scores between 0 and 1, 0 being the lowest and 1 being the more positive. So 1 means he's happy or it is a positive comment, and 0 means it's more negative and is not happy. So such a thing we can able to classify. So after we get that column, you need to group it out to make it more visual, because the values between ranging from 0 to 1, all the point like 0.01, 0.51, 0.52, it will be more than hundreds of values, right, based on the different scores. Let us wait for the score. Yes, it has come. You can see the score sentiment, and this is an average. And let us see some of the positive sentiments over here. You can see the 9.95. Let us try to check this text. Just read McDonald's is actually running more ads than before. Economically slowed down. Great. Because of the word great, they mentioned the sentiment can be positive. When you see this is 0.13, which is seems like win-win situation. We need to check it for this. Oh no, I just read they are going to do remake of Girls Just Wanna Have Fun. Stop it, Hollywood, just stop. So it's saying like something like stop it, some kind of harsh words that makes a negative sentiment, right? That is what it is, 0.13. So this is what sentiment analytics, that you, in order to build such a system, you need to get it, you need to understand the NLP, you need to train your model, everything. But in terms of Power BI, they have trained a lot of words like this on their own. Then you are using that model. Internally, it is going to call one model that is deployed in the Power BI in some location, right? That is the logic behind that. So in terms of text, you can do all the services like key phrase extraction, language detection, and sentimental analysis. In case of image, you can go for vision, and you can also use the Azure machine learning tools as well. So I hope this functionality is like premium capacity. I'm pretty much not sure. Once I'm aware of this, I will definitely make a video on this. For now, then what you can do, based on the values over here, we can categorize from 0 to 0.25, it will be negative, and 0.25 to 0.50 or 0.50, it will be close to negative. Then 0.50 to 0.75, it's neutral. Then 0.75 to 1, it will be positive comments. Based on this, you can create a custom column that we are aware of, those who are familiar with Power BI. So then you can visualize. Once you close this one, these columns will act as a normal column in your Power BI reports. From here, you can create a visuals that most of the people are aware of who are watching this video. So this is the power you will get. And one more thing I want to show here is like the auto ML ML functionality, where you can able to create your machine learning models. Where you can create is like, you need to go to data flows. Once you have a data flows, right? So in the data flows, there is option over here. I have created one model, prediction model, where you can create your machine learning model. Let us try to create one, add machine learning model, and you can go through these steps, like select a column to predict. So this is sales, and you have some column, what columns you want to predict, right? So I don't have any classification. Let us go for item type. I don't have a proper data set to create a machine learning model. Just you want to aware that what kind of capabilities you will get. I'm just choosing the item type, right? So basically, from the input table, you want to choose whether this customer will buy it or not, right? That is the binary prediction. And the another thing is like, you can have a general classification, as it mentioned, the classifying credit card applicants into groups of those who have good credit, bad credit, or those that require further analysis. So you can have a different kind of classification. So your outcome should be like that. So here the sales and this outcome, whether if it is a binary, whether the what you are going to predict, you have to train your model. First of all, like you you based on the different parameters, if this customer is 30 to 45 years age and he is having this much salary and he is living in Chennai or the main cities, then there is a possibility that this particular customer can buy the product, right? Any new products come. So this will be trained based on the old data. So that is what it is. So outcome column, you should already have some column here. That is whether this customer will buy or not. And all the inputs are from here, like what is his age, what is his salary, where it is he is located, everything, right? And that is what it is, binary. And general classification, like he there can be like he is having good credit score, he is not having a bad credit score, and then he require further classification. There are 3 to 4 or many classifications kind of prediction, then you can go for it. Regression model, it is like predicting numbers, how much he can purchase, right? That is the one. So just we will go and see how it works. So we will go for general classification in this case. So what are the things you need to apply, right? Input, give it as input. As I said before, from which location, what is his name, what is his customer group name, from which city, what is his salary. There is no salary details here. I'm saying what are the inputs you need to provide to your model so that it will train. So those things you need to select here and then click on next. Then give a name to your model, sales, purchase, sales, product, prediction. Okay, see, typically I don't have any data set to train the model. I'm trying to explain how you can build a machine learning model. This is not the way you can build a machine learning model, but Power BI team has made auto ML automatically. This is all these things you might have code these things, but here in Power BI for the Power BI premium per user, they are giving you this facility. Save and train. Now once you do that, and there are certain settings you can do, I will do definitely a better video on this, especially related to machine learning model. But for you to aware, like just give you a glimpse about the Power BI premium per user AI facilities. I'm trying to create this model without having proper data set. So once you create it, we will see the model, whether it's trained or how you can deploy everything in our upcoming videos. But for now, we have seen like the different AI facilities you will get when you have Power BI premium per user. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.